season you are right now. It might be darkness season. It might be rainy season. It might be dry season. I don't care to know. All I know, God is here to take you out of that trouble. Devil is a liar. It doesn't matter the load they put on you. It doesn't matter the trouble they put on you. As long as you know who you are, you must get to where you are. Whatever has come to your life to break you down, I command that thing out of your life. Everything. There is no other God before you. After you, there is no. You are the beginning. Thank you, Father. Receive the praise. Lord, right now, speak to us. Through your word, speak to us, Father, and change us. In Jesus' mighty name. Let me hear your email. I told them. As a Christian, you must know the reason of your living so that you will not live for nothing. Tell anybody, you must know the reason of your living. Many people don't know why they are living. That is why they are living by accident. They are after the problem they met here on earth. Those troubles you are seeing, they are not for you. First of all, as a Christian, know why you are existing. Know why you are living. Know why you are looking for what you are looking for. Know why you want to get married. Know why. Live with a purpose. Tell people, live with a purpose. Tell another person, say, live with a purpose. Don't be after problem. Don't. The more you grow, the more you grow, the more the problem you find here on earth is here. We met them. They are not for us. Say, they are not for me. They are not for you. You met them here on earth. The more you grow up, the more the challenges you see. Yes, our young boys and girls here now, they never face challenge in their life because they never reach. Are you hearing me? Until when they marry, they start getting jobs, then they'll see their own nice to bath and eat, paint their face. Their challenge never come, am I right? But when they marry, trouble says, see me, I don't come home. That is why you need strength. Tell everybody you need strength. Many of you are praying for many blessings, but no strength. You are praying for blessings. God should uplift you, but you don't have strength. You don't have power. You are praying for something you cannot carry. Before you pray for power, for something, ask God to give you strength to handle them. Are you hearing me? Listen to me. Many people lack wisdom right now. Wisdom, no wisdom. Be a Christian with a difference. Can you see how the devil is fighting the whole world? The whole world is shaking. Today you can hardly differentiate who is a Christian. You can't know who is a Christian because everybody are after trouble. Let me hear your amen. Amen. The trouble you are seeing in the whole world is not government. It's what? It's Satan. Tell the boy it's Satan. Amen. Lucifer is fighting the people of God. Lucifer is aware that Jesus is coming very soon. So Lucifer and devil, they are fighting day and night to make sure nobody is standing for God. And really, nobody is standing again. It's a shame when today when you call for somebody to do something in church, you will be provoked. But when you go outside, the same person will buy, use 40,000 to buy beer for unbeliever. Say everybody should carry one bottle. Have you ever observed it? It happened out there. It happened. But the same person cannot pay for one bag of cement in church. Lucifer blind them. Know the reason of your living. Last week, I was sharing with you our title. Don't let today's trouble to stop your future plans. It's what is happening now. If you ask in church now, what are your plans for tomorrow? Nobody have plan. If you say, if money come, if they read budget, I will get plan. Also, you are living for budget. If you are living for budget, let me see your hand. Don't live for money. Tell people, don't live for money. Live for destiny. Live for future. Tell people, live for destiny. Budget. When they read budget, and we have plan. Don't live for budget. Without Nigeria budget, the whole world will still continue, am I right? Yes. Without the budget, God is God. Today I want to share with you what I title. For the past 2 weeks, there's a topic I started. I said, don't let today's trouble stop your future plans. How many of you enjoy that topic? Let me go back a little bit. Your today trouble, your today challenges, your today needs, the thing you need today, don't allow them to affect your future. The things you're needing today, don't allow them to affect your future. Today's topic is fear not. Tell them about fear not.
Fear not.
Be confident of who you are. Say, I refuse to fear. That's the topic. Fear not. Be confident of who you are. Ask yourself a question. Who am I? Ask your neighbor. Say, who are you?
Who are you?
If you know who you are, let me see your hand. Be confident of who you are. Believe in yourself. No matter what you are facing, no matter what you are seeing, refuse to fear. Fear is our greatest enemy. Fear is our greatest enemy. It's a torment. Fear is a torment. And the reason of the fear is lack of love. When love is not in you, you will always be full of fear. Lack of love, that is why you are full of fear. You are not confident of who you are, you'll be full of fear. You are not sure of who you are. You always see yourself as a woman or as a man, but you are not sure of who you are. That is why fear robbed people. Are you listening to me? The untimely death you are seeing today is as a result of fear. Your baby is sick, but because of your fear, you have a greater sickness. After the baby gets well, you will not have diabetes, or you will have hypertension because of your baby's fever. Fever now give you hypertension. It's you that they are not treating now because of fear. Say, I refuse to fear. Don't allow things to make you fear. The Bible says God never give to us the spirit of fear. Hallelujah. God never give his children the spirit of fear. He said, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. If you are full of fear, you are not of God, because God never gave to us the spirit of fear. Why are you afraid? Who tell you that you will die? Who told you? Who told you sickness can kill you? HIV is a sickness. It can't kill you. It's fear that kill. In fact, yellow fever kill people more than HIV. I was told that when yellow fever came out, when your family have yellow fever, they will pack and leave you. Are you hearing me? HIV is even better. It's the shock, it's the fear that causes what? Death. Say, I will never die. Refuse to fear. Refuse it. Don't allow anything to make you trouble. Refuse to fear. Jesus Christ said, let not your heart be troubled. Neither be afraid. Let not your heart be troubled. Say, I refuse to be troubled. Let not your heart be troubled. No matter who disappointed you, it doesn't matter. God will appoint you. No matter who disappoints you, God will appoint you. Are you all listening to me? So don't give up no matter what you are facing. Don't allow fear, because fear is a torment. 1 John said, fear is a torment. He said, he that feareth is not made perfect in love. Fear is a torment. He said, there is no fear in love, for perfect love casteth out fear. When the love of God is in you, fear can never live in you. Are you listening to me? Where there is love, there is no fear. It's only when you lack love, you'll be wrapped up with fear. Hallelujah. As a child of God, train yourself on how not to be afraid. You must train yourself on how not to be afraid. Train yourself like that. Train yourself on how not to be afraid, no matter what. Boldness is what God gave to us. Boldness. Unshakable. Boldness. Unmovable. No matter what is going on around you, you are not worried. You are bold. Why? Because Christ is there. I say Christ is there. Refuse to fear. Say I refuse to fear. Shake it. Say I refuse to fear. God called Abraham in Genesis chapter 15. He said, Abraham, fear not. I am the shield. What is she? Protector. I am your protector. He said, I am that shield. He said, fear not. What are the things that bring fears in you? What are the things that make you fear? Refuse to fear. Remove your mind from fear. Don't allow fear in your house. Don't allow fear in your life. Fear is a torment. It's what the devil is using to torment people of God. Fear. Fear brings folly. When you are afraid, you'll be falling. Fear, tell them about fear, bring folly. It brings folly. The moment you are afraid, you'll be falling. You will go astray. So don't allow fear in your heart. Train your heart. The way you train your children, train yourself on how not to be afraid again. Is it the complaint and the murmuring that will bring the blessing? You just sit down in your house, you close the door, say, will that change anything? No, rather you are going down. Philip can say, be careful for nothing. That's what Paul said. He said, be careful for nothing. Be anxious for nothing. Why are you worrying for nothing? You are not the owner of this world. The owner said, all things are possible. Are you hearing me? The owner of the world says, all things are possible. Say, I refuse to fear. Say it to yourself. Shout it, say, I refuse to fear. No matter what I face, say, I refuse to fear. From today on, I refuse to fear. Say, I am confident of who I am. Say, I am a king. I am changing my world. Anywhere I go, I make different. Say, I am a builder. I am a life builder. I cannot be put to shame. Say, I am a life builder. I am a world builder. I am changing my world. Anywhere I enter, changes come. I refuse to fear. Tell yourself, say, I refuse to fear. Type your chest, say, I refuse to fear. There are many things that the devil brought to bring fear, just to activate fear in you. You came from work, you met your baby sick, fear gripped you. Now, sickness come. Be careful how you react to many things around you. Be careful your reaction. No matter what you hear, be careful your reaction, the way you react. Are you hearing me? You don't get to see high blood pressure. For what? Go and check for what? Because a boy disappointed you. You not allowed high blood pressure. A boy disappointed you. Sickness not appoint you. No, my God. You are miracle. The season you are right now. It might be darkness season. It might be rainy season. It might be dry season. I don't care to know. All I know, God is here to take you out of that trouble. Devil is a liar. It doesn't matter the load they put on you. It doesn't matter the trouble they put on you. As long as you know who you are, you must get to where you are. Whatever that comes to your life to bring you down, I command that thing out of your life. Say, that is not my story. A boy disappointed you. Instead of you to allow God to appoint you, sickness appoint you. No, that shouldn't be your story. All things work together for good. No matter who disappoints you, it doesn't matter. No matter what you face, it doesn't matter. With God, all things are possible. Say, I refuse to be troubled. Shit again, say, I refuse to be troubled. Genesis 15, let's go there quickly. I read from verse 1, Genesis 15. After this thing, the word of the Lord came unto Abram in a vision, saying, fear not, Abram, I am thy shield and the exceeding great reward. And Abraham said, Lord God, what wilt thou give me, seeing I go childless, and the steward of my house is this Eliezer of Damascus? Verse 3. And Abraham said, Behold, to me thou hast given no seed, and lo, one born in my house is my heir. Verse 4. And behold, the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, This shall not be thy heir, but him that shall come forth out of thy own bosom shall be what? Thy heir. Verse 5. And he brought him forth abroad, and said, Look now towards heaven, and tell the star, if thou be able to number them. And he said unto him, So shall thy seed be. Verse 6. And Abraham believed what? And he what? He believed the Lord, and he counted to him as what? Righteousness. God said, Fear not. That is what I want you to see there. Fear not, even if you are childless. Abraham was childless for 100 years, but yet God said, Fear not. There is no baby, no hope of having baby. Sarah was barren, no hope of having baby. But yet, God arose in the middle of the night and woke him up and said, Fear not. That means there is hope for you. Are you listening to me? That is what God is showing you. That means there is hope. That is what God is telling him. Fear not. That means there is hope. There is hope. Even if you are childless, God is telling you, Fear not. Refuse to fear. Refuse to fear. Are you listening to me? Fear not, no matter what you are facing. Disappointment, no matter what you are facing. Torment, hunger, listen. Fear not. Tell them, fear not. This is the medium the devil is using to torment the people of God. Fear, true fear. This is the medium the devil is using to torment the people of God. True fear. The devil will tell you that you have HIV. That fear will be activated in you. From that moment, your physical body and your spiritual body will start dying. Listen, I restore your mind back this morning. The moment you hear that news, listen, your physical body will start dying. You start reacting to that sickness. God is telling you this morning through me, he said, Fear not.
You are the one that what?
You are using the sister against her.
This one. You say your name is what?
Pastor.
You are pastor? Pastor at what? Why you enter? Pastor, why you come?
I come because you are disturbing me.
Because I'm disturbing you?
Yes.
You are a fake pastor. You are a fake pastor. Where is it? Where are you? Where do you come from? From Kaduna?
Kaduna.
You are Kaduna?
Yes.
And you are a pastor in church?
Yes.
Oh my God. Come here, baby. You are a pastor in church?
I said yes. I
Oh, you came because I'm disturbing you?
Yes.
How am I disturbing you?
You are disturbing her because you give her that useless prayer, whatever you call it, you want.
Useless what? So she's disturbing you now.
She's praying a lot.
She's praying a lot.
Yes.
Who are you to her, you pastor?
I'm a pastor to her sister.
You are a pastor to her sister?
Yes.
Now they hear so. Every church, every woman they go, we just say Jesus is Lord, whom you enter. Jesus is Lord, whom you don't enter. You are a pastor to the sister. Then what did you come to do in my ministry?
I come because
you want me.
I'm using the sister.
Yes.
And now I'll be tormenting her.
Yes.
And now
ask her to you.
I refuse to help her.
Yes.
Now you help her.
I help her.
Yes.
You the pastor.
You get the house for her.
I get the house for her.
Yes.
Why did you help her? You want to sleep with her. Why?
Because I want to take whatever she has.
Oh, you want to take whatever she has?
Yes. That's because what the power that I have has inspired.
The power you have?
Yes.
You pastor. You the pastor.
Yes.
You have power?
Of course.
Jesus Christ. Which power? The power is from where?
What
are you using the power to do, pastor?
And this is to perform miracles.
To perform miracle?
Yes.
Women, when I hear so.
Hey.
To perform miracle?
Yes. And her sister like miracles.
You like
miracles? But this one, this Esther, she's so stubborn. The first day they take her to the church, I was trying to take something away. But
you were trying to take something away?
Yes. But she's strong. Since she left the church, she said, no, I'm not going to Christ the ultimate, I mean, whatever you call it. Yes. The sister was angry.
You see, Dave, they give you Christ the ultimate.
Yes.
But you are using charm to do miracle.
Of course. I didn't sleep with her.
Okay. Take her destiny.
Because she can pray.
Oh.
If I take that one,
finish.
She will not pray.
You normally sleep with women like that?
Of course. Especially the ones that are in need.
That you are in need?
Yes.
When you not sleep with them, what are you removing?
They are
star.
Yes. Their
what will not happen to their life, their destiny?
Don't be useless. Nobody to assist. Nobody to manage.
You are a pastor. You have a church.
I said yes.
People come to your church.
Well, where? Of course.
More than my own here. They come. You use charm to pray for them.
Yes.
What will not happen to their destiny?
It will be nothing. They will just be like ants.
Ants.
Yes.
And you know that they are not getting blessed.
I don't know. At times I give people because I want them to bring their relatives. So that I can
take what belongs to them.
Yes.
Who gave you the power, the charm?
Where else? I collect it from the water.
From the water?
Yes.
How many you enter the water? Who took you there?
I went to Babalawo, of course.
Okay.
Yes. Did you hear my name? Ayeni.
Ayeni? What is the meaning of Ayeni?
Ayeni.
Ayunto. What is the meaning of Ayeni?
Why should I tell you?
So people didn't know that you are using charm in the church?
How will they know? They won't know.
Oh.
But this girl, she's stubborn. The very day she entered, she said, I'm not going there.
Oh.
Because she sees something there.
Oh.
Yes.
Wherever you go, that they change your star and restore your star back. The places you will enter, your destiny will be lost. See, Pastor. Food, Pastor. Catch on her, cute pastor. Oh, assuming your opportunity to sleep with this girl, you will take her destiny away. The girl went to her to rent her. He said, Pastor, please help me to rent her. He said, I must be your boyfriend before I will help you. The girl said no. Since then, you have been angry. Let me see how you are.
That's why I sent her to Mabuchi.
You sent her to Mabuchi?
Yes.
Just to destroy her.
Just to destroy her.
Now, we remove
and
her
now
there.
You.
I remove her there.
You.
Yes.
You.
Yes.
Do you know that I
senior
you?
You senior me?
I senior you.
How did you know? Because I have small body.
You
are
a small boy.
I'm a small boy.
Even
if
you look at your face,
I'm a small
boy. Yes, I senior you.
You say,
no, take what I want. Okay.
I take what you want.
Yes.
But I didn't sleep with her now.
I know. That's why the very pastor she came to your office, she
yes.
said, this man is different.
Jesus Christ. Glad of Jesus Christ. How many women have you slept with like that?
Women are longer.
Eh? Women. Not longer. Longer. Women are longer. Not true. You sleep with many of them. Both are married women.
Even in some of the members in the church. But you will not know.
You will not know.
It's just between me and them. When they come to church, you will tell them that if you come to church,
just pretend to.
You don't know me. After church, you can meet.
Yes, so. That is how many persons do yes with that. Yes, they got us. Oh, that is how you build your church.
Of course.
Jesus Christ will disgrace you now.
For me, even this Wednesday, I call her.
You call her often?
Yes.
Physically?
Yes, but she didn't know it's me.
Yes.
Because I told myself.
Yes.
I said hello. Is this Esther Matthew? She said no. This is Esther Sonny.
Oh my God. Glad of Jesus Christ.
She said she's even using your name, isn't it?
He said he's even using your name. Oh, she said this is Esther Sonny.
She said this is Esther Sonny.
Jesus Christ.
She's not from where? Say, I don't know you, so I won't tell you where.
My God.
But my name is Esther Sonny.
Jesus. Glad of Jesus Christ. The demon came in Jesus and the Holy Ghost revealed it to her. She's not the one talking, everybody, the viewers. She's not the one talking, it's the demon that is speaking through her. Hallelujah. So you don't like as I help her?
I don't like it. You know, since she come here, even food to eat is difficult, but you will never know. She's too stubborn.
Yes.
She will never know.
You don't like me?
I don't like you because you are helping me. Even to just get the prayer booklet and do whatever you want. She don't have money. Well, somebody gave her consolation.
She's praying with it.
She's using it. And when I called after that, she picked up the prayer book. She said, number 5. Yes. Just don't even look. Back to Kenya.
Back to Kenya.
Waiting now.
He said number 5.
Sonny, what? Just leave her. Because her sister has been using.
You don't like my ministry?
I don't like it. Why should I like it? I will never like it.
Why are you using her sister?
That one. Babalawo.
She there is that.
Anywhere she goes there.
She will go there.
Anywhere they say na prayer, she must be there. If she called this small one.
Say are you able there. To sleep with that one?
That one I'll confirm now. It's confirmed.
It's confirmed?
Yes.
You are just enjoying all the women in the church.
I'm enjoying it.
Both fast and slim one. They enjoy all of them. My women are pity, you. And my own women have come out here, they fear them. Because if they don't fit up to me face to face, they feel disgrace me. You understand? The man, the woman, who you say may not come home, before not place, it's not be true, not like them. They fear women, when they come out, it's that they fear. My civil chair, I'll turn and go back. I'll dress and go walk. The fear women. Ministry, I would, and the God has seen woman, come scatter and come out.
They miss something.
And they miss something. Is that they miss enjoyment? Oh, now enjoyment?
Yes.
I get wife now.
So what?
You don't have wife?
If I have one.
You get wife?
Beautiful wife.
Beautiful wife?
Yes.
Why are you cheating on her?
If I didn't do that, there
will
not be power for me to
come. Okay, it's true that woman is getting power. The more you sleep with women, the more the power increases. Oh, tell your neighbor, be careful. In this way, Jack, I can't church for you. It's not all to seven. The whole way, Jack, the real church is not to seven. Forget about the name. Forget it. It's not the name. Oh, you could not get the extras on it. As he's getting my name, are you angry? Yes.
Everything is
Sonny.
Her dog is Sonny.
Her dog, Sonny.
Her room is
Sonny. Sonny. Everywhere, Sonny.
Everywhere is Sonny.
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 Sonny. You will bring someone. I have already seen it. I will protect her.
For me.
I want to open business for her now.
Never.
I want to open business for her.
Shall you told her?
Yes.
It's not that you have money before you open up.
Yes.
She started looking around.
Yes.
Looking at the place.
Yes.
This place will be good for me. Yes. By the grace of God, I will overtake
Jesus.
It. I'm the daughter of Jesus.
Jesus Christ.
I'm different.
Glad for Jesus.
I'm different. Okay. You different, Abby? You different, Abby?
We shall see. You say I am missing. You want me to be sleeping with women?
Yes, now. I'm missing. And if you can look all around like this.
Yes.
You just go like this,
they will follow me.
Yes.
Okay, man, look around.
I'm trying you! You're making choice of me.
Yes, you're a bad man. You're a bad man, destroying the destinies of women. God will deliver you. I pray for every one of you. Whatever you must have gone, and they take your star away. I return your star back to you. You're a